Hi, good afternoon, and thank you. My name is David. I come from an NGO, Food and Water Europe. We are based in Brussels, and we campaign for public water and for water as a common good. We are members of an NGO based in the United States. First of all, thank you for the organizing of the event. It's been really interesting, and it's been really encouraging for us. I'm going to try to be quite short, because I think that many people of you came from far away, and I find it more interesting to have more interventions from the public, because before it was being quite interesting, especially because also Yorgos wants to speak, and Yorgos was really, he needs to take some time. Also because, as Jan was explaining, after the ECI, you know, so we are here in Brussels, we try to convince the European Commission. So there's this ECI, this European Citizen Initiative, that collects 2 million signatures, the Economic and Social Committee, the European Parliament with a report, even the Pope, and what we get is nothing. No, so as Lynn was mentioning before, the European Commission is acting really in an arrogant way in this topic. And as Jan was saying, it's in the best way to broaden the gap between European citizens and European institutions. So for us, it's really inspiring to have you here to give some inputs and take profit that you have MEPs and a lot of people around here, so to provide your ideas and your what do you think we can do next together. This morning, I had the chance to discuss with some people coming from Greece that are recording a documentary, and they are over there. And they were asking about this contradiction of while in the northern countries, like Paris and Berlin, they are remunicipalizing water supply, water services, the European Commission is forcing countries in the south to privatize, no? And if this is like a kind of a center-periphery a conflict, that for me it's more like a, and the ECI was a proof of that, it's more a conflict between the European elites and the European citizens, no? Jan was mentioning, every time we campaign together at local level, we win, because this is something that is really clear for everybody. But when we get like up in the chain of command or in the power chain, we find this wall, no? And this in regarding water has been really evident. So this is more like a citizens between this elite, and we see that every time that citizens block the new initiative to privatize water, the neoliberal elites, the European Commission, industry, are coming with another way to privatize. We were still resisting in southern countries austerity, no? Like in Greece, Portugal, the examples that we have listened, but also like in a different way in Spain or Italy. While in Greece they are still resisting, you are still resisting this wave, we have another wave through trade agreements. And Jan already mentioned them. We have three agreements on the trade agreements on the table that can pose risks to our model of public water management. And especially one, CETA, the one that is already signed with Canada, is going to be voted in the coming weeks. So tomorrow there is this vote in the Committee for Environment. And beginning or mid-February, it's going to be voted in plenary. What are the problems of these trade agreements to the model of public water that we stand for, to the things that we are achieving, no, and with the struggles at local, regional, or national level? On one hand, on the ECI, we asked for water to be out of any liberalization schemes for, you know, internal market rules, and what the European Commission is always saying while negotiating these agreements that are negotiated in secret is that water is not on the table. No, they are never negotiating about water. In this trade agreement with Canada, CETA, we have the text, and there is an article about water. And what do they say? They say that water in its natural form is not a good that can be traded. But we know that all the uses of water are of water that is not in their natural state. No? So in a subtle way, they are promoting water commodification. No? And they are putting water, and especially water rights, under the scheme of trade and investment rules. That is something really dangerous. This is on one hand. On the other hand, water services, the European Commission is always saying that they are protected in these trade agreements through an exception clause that is that they call for public utilities, that we think is not strong enough. On one hand, the human right to water is the human right to water and sanitation, and only Germany, of all the European countries, took reservations for sanitation. So that means that for the rest of the European countries, sanitation services are open to liberalization under this framework. And on the other hand, this clause is not enough because the kind of trade agreements that are being signed now are different. They are done in a different way of liberalizing everything except the few things that you list in an annex. And also we are signing or negotiating agreements with really powerful countries with a stronger interest in European public services. And we have one of the main concerns of these agreements, you know, like CETA, is the investment protection mechanisms, like these mechanisms that transnational companies can use to take a government to a court if they take a decision to protect the environment or to remunicipalize water because it's a threat to their profits. But about remunicipalization, Emmanuel is going to talk before. We are not the only ones complaining about CETA and water. By the way, with the European Water Movement, we produced a guide for activists with a lot of information about the what are the risks and the main arguments that we found. There are some copies on the table. Otherwise, we can send it via email. I think that is even translated into Greek. When we complain about this, we are not alone, because even governments like the Slovenian government was raising a lot of questions to the European Commission before signing the treaty regarding the impact that this treaty can have in a problem that our Slovenian colleague was mentioning before of the concessions that were granted to the drinking industry. No, there is only one company, Heineken, the beer company, that owns more than the 50% of the water used for the food and drinking industry in Slovenia. So under this framework of CETA, if the Slovenian government tries to take this water back, they risk to be taken into one of these international courts. So it's a real problem. That is not something that the social movements, we like to do scaremongering and we like to create artificial fears. It's something that is real, and the governments also are raising their questions. CETA is going to be voted during February here in the European Parliament, but then it needs to come back to the national parliaments, and it's going to be voted by every country. So, I mean, let's see what happens. I want to be optimistic as well today. This is a combative year. Let's see what happens in the European Parliament, but don't forget that this is going to be voted in your Parliament, so you still have a say, no, at national level. About how to move forward, as Jan was saying, the answer from the European Commission to the ECI was simply a compilation of things that were already going on, and what the European Commission does the best, that is to put everything into a bureaucratic mess that nobody can understand, only professional lobbyists from industry and themselves, and where civil society, we don't have the resources or the mechanisms to really have an impact. What we need during this year is basically you. No, we need to mobilize at national and local level to try somehow to close this gap that we were talking before, no, between what the citizens want at local level, and they show it every time that they are asked, and what the European Commission is doing here in Brussels. We listened to really good examples from Slovenia. The Greek case is a really good example on how people never get tired of fighting. So if we want, as Mr. Deck was mentioning, to stop water being a product, we need to mobilize really tough this year to remind the Commission that they need to follow the ECI, that putting water in trade agreements is against citizens' will and is going to be detrimental to their position. And at some point, we need mobilization to try to bring this your voice into the Brussels mess. And thanks a lot, and looking forward to listen to what you have to say about it.